Australia and New Zealand have widely varied vegetation that are discovered no place else on Earth. Australia is particular since it is an island, a country, and a mainland, the littlest of the world's landmasses. No other landmass can associatively make those three cases. Australia comprises of an enormous terrain and the island of Tasmania toward the south. The primary actual zone of New Zealand, then again, comprises of two principal islands isolated from Australia's southeastern district by the Tasman Sea. Australia is encircled by different oceans. The Indian Ocean encompasses its western and southern coasts. Indonesia and Papua New Guinea lie toward the north, isolated by the Timor Sea and the Arafura Sea. The Gulf of Carpentaria recognizes Cape York, which expands north along Australia's eastern coast nearly to Papua New Guinea. The Great Barrier Reef runs for in excess of 1,600 miles off the landmass northeastern shores. The Coral Sea isolates the Great Barrier Reef from the South Pacific. The southern side of Australia is the Great Australian Bight and the island of Tasmania. A bight is an enormous, wide sound. Toward the south of Australia and New Zealand is Antarctica. The two nations have particular actual geologies. Australia is generally level with low-height good countries and a broad dry inside, while New Zealand has high mountains and gets satisfactory precipitation. The noteworthy separation of New Zealand and Australia from the remainder of the world has caused creatures and living beings that are not found elsewhere to create in these two nations. The interesting biodiversity incorporates marsupials, or creatures whose youthful are brought up in the mother's pocket, like kangaroos, wallabies, koalas, and bandicoots. It is accepted that these animals grew independently after the mainland split away from one another in excess of 200 million years prior. Many plant species are likewise interesting to this domain. The biodiversity found here is discrete from that of Asia. This has been clarified by different biogeographers by drawing fanciful lines only north of Australia to demonstrate the line of division between the Asian domain and the Austral domain. Wallace's line and Weber's line are two such models. The two models endeavor to set up the right line of division for the distinctions in species advancement between the different sides. During the Ice Ages, ocean level was lower, and the numerous islands of Southeast Asia were associated via land to the territory. Papua New Guinea was associated with Australia. Wallace and Weber accepted that no land connect associated the Asian side with the Austral side for creatures to get over. This division made the life forms the south to grow freely of those in the north. For instance, marsupials are not found on the Asian side of these lines yet are found on the Australian side. Imperialism. New Zealand and Australia were both occupied before the period of European expansionism. Native individuals are said to have moved to Australia across Southeast Asia from the territory of Asia in excess of 40,000 years prior. They made Australia their home and adjusted to the actual topography of the landmass. For a huge number of years before the Europeans showed up, the Aborigines cut out a presence in Australia and built up their social ways. Just around 450,000 Aborigines stay in Australia today. New Zealand was possessed by the Polynesian gathering called the Maori who set up themselves on the islands in the 10th century. For many years they, as well, settled their way of life and customs in the area before the Europeans showed up. The Aborigines in Australia and the Maori in New Zealand were both gone up against with the European intruders. From their stance, there was a lot to lose by the appearance of the Europeans. Terrains were lost, new infections slaughtered many, and control of their strategies for job were taken over by Europeans. The Maori started various fights British colonizers, yet in the end the more noteworthy military force acquired the benefit. Right now, the Maori make up under 10% of the number of inhabitants in New Zealand. The locating of Australia by the Dutch dates to 1606. Portuguese adventurers may have found Australia before, however there are no set-up accounts. In the mid-1700s, the northern and western coastlines of Australia were known as New Holland. There were no settled states. James Cook, a maritime official working for the British Naval Force, directed the Great Boat Endeavour and planned Australia's eastern coast in 1770. He made port at Botany Bay, only south of the current city of Sydney, and guaranteed the district for Britain. He named the land New South Wales. The diagramming of the coast brought about proceeded with consideration being paid to the district. In the interim, England had an extreme issue with congestion of its detainment facilities. Its concern was exacerbated by the deficiency of Britain's American provinces. Upon Cook's revisitation of England, premium was created in the idea of diminishing jail packing by sending detainees to Australia. In 1787, 11 boats with 750 convicts cruised from Great Britain to Botany Bay. Jail provinces were set up in Australia. Before the finish of the 17th century, the whole Australian mainland was under the British Crown. While the development of detainees from England to Australia was lessening, the following influx of movement was being powered by the disclosure of gold during the 1850s. The act of moving detainees to Australia finished in 1868. The appearance of the Europeans had caused a genuine downfall in the Aboriginal populace. Natives were totally crushed in Tasmania. In 1901, the different regions and territories of Australia met up under one league called the Commonwealth of Australia. Another government capital city of Canberra was proposed. By 1927, Canberra was prepared for government action. This ward government actually considered individual state contrasts. The British ruler is viewed as the head of state, however, it is essentially a formal position. There have been developments inside Australia lately to isolate from the British Crown, however they have not been endorsed. Australia has a fairly chosen government. English maritime official James Cook planned the coastline of New Zealand in 1769. As the pioneer time arose, Great Britain claimed New Zealand and included it with its province of New South Wales. During the 1840s, New Zealand turned into a different Crown province. The province built up a nearby parliament and an agent government. By 1893, New Zealand stood out as truly newsworthy as the primary country on the planet, giving all ladies the option to cast a ballot. As a piece of the British Empire, the nation was made a district country in 1947 and has been working autonomously from that point forward. There is a global appreciation for the island mainland of Australia, and the fascination has filled in power in the previous few decades. The travel industry is presently the main financial action in Australia. Just somewhat more modest in actual territory than the mainland United States, Australia is a huge country with numerous assets, however, couple of individuals comparative with its size. The Tropic of Capricorn runs directly through the center of this country. Australia has numerous novel types of plants and creatures, including marsupials and a large group of toxic snakes and creepy crawlies. With the appearance of European imperialism, new species were acquainted with the country, which lamentably caused the eradication of a portion of the local species, yet in addition gave Australia a wide variety of living beings and common conditions. Australia is a moderately low-lying island with low help. It is the flattest of the relative multitude of mainlands. The different high country ranges are articulated, however, are not high in height. The Great Dividing Range is a mountain chain stretching out from Melbourne in the south to Cape York in the north. This low-lying scope of high country's midpoints around 4,000 feet and arrives at a height of a little more than 7,000 feet at its most elevated tops in the south. The biggest stream in Australia is the Darling Murray River framework that begins in the high country of the Great Dividing Range and streams internal through New South Wales, Queensland, Victoria, and South Australia. The incredible inside of the nation is home to the monstrous outback. Expanding west from the Great Dividing Range, the outback incorporates the greater part of the inside. This area gets less precipitation than along the coast, and its landscape comprises of deserts and semi-arid levels with unpleasant grasses and scrublands. The outback is scantily populated, however is home to various native gatherings. A considerable lot of the youngsters in the outback have generally gotten their school exercises through TV or radio stations as a result of their separation. Mining and some rural exercises can be found in the outback. Alice Springs is situated in the focal point of the mainland and has been given the assignment of the center of no place, or the focal point of everything. The deserts of Australia's inside make up a huge part of the mainland. Western Australia has three huge deserts, the Gibson Desert, Great Victoria Desert, and Great Sandy Desert. The Simpson Desert is situated in the boundary locale between the Northern Territory, Queensland, and South Australia. These deserts are not all sand. Coarse grasses and different types of spinifex, a short plant that fills in sandy soil, likewise fill in the deserts. The Great Artesian Basin on the western edge of the Great Dividing Range gets almost no precipitation. It would be delegated a desert yet for its underground water assets, which support broad cultivating tasks. Huge domesticated animals organizations exist in Australia's inside with gigantic crowds of steers and sheep. The verdant levels and scrublands give brushing to tamed animals and surprisingly wild camels. The Great Barrier Reef, the biggest boundary reef on the planet, stretches out for 1,600 miles off the northeastern shore of Australia. It is home to a large group of ocean animals and fish that draw a great many sightseers every year. The reef draws in scuba jumpers and water fans from around the world. The reef is a fundamental the travel industry fascination and carries pay to the Australian economy. The Great Barrier Reef has been assigned as a United Nations World Heritage Site. Brisbane is situated on the Gold Coast, which gets its name from the lovely sandy seashores. The seashores draw in a significant the travel industry market for the country. Two or three huge actual highlights of interest and importance to Australia are the two biggest stone monuments on the planet. In Western Australia, in excess of 500 miles toward the upper east of Perth, is Mount Augustus National Park, which includes the stone known as Mount Augustus. It is viewed as the biggest single stone on the planet. Mount Augustus transcends the desert scene. The single construction is around 5 miles in length. Mount Augustus is more than twice the size of the most celebrated Australian stone monument of Uluru, Ayers Rock. Uluru is situated around 200 miles southwest of Alice Springs in the Northern Territory and is a notable vacation spot. Uluru transcends the outback and is about 2.2 miles long. The two rocks hold huge social worth to the native populaces in Australia. The two of them have antiquated petroglyphs, and both are viewed as consecrated locales. Uluru has been more advocated through the travel industry advancements. Environment regions. Focal and Western Australia are meagerly populated. Enormous zones of the Northern Territory and the desert areas are uninhabited. Around 40% of Australia's inside is desert, where Type B environments overwhelm. The enormous landmass can warm up throughout the mid-year months, setting off high temperatures. Low mugginess permits warmth to escape into the climate after the sun goes down, so there is wide temperature variety among day and night. Along the northern waterfront area there are more tropical type and environments. Nearer to the equator and with the ocean to direct temperatures, the northern territories around Darwin and Cape York have little temperature variety. Temperatures in Darwin normal around 90 degrees Fahrenheit in the late spring and 86 degrees Fahrenheit in the colder time of year. Spring storms carry extra precipitation from February to March. Tasmania, Victoria, and the center area of the southeast have a more moderate and calm Type C environment. The fundamental urban communities, like Sydney, Melbourne, and Adelaide, are inside this region. It isn't astounding that there is an immediate connection between Type C environments and the significant populous zones. The Tropic of Capricorn cuts across the landmass, showing that the urban areas are not that far south of the jungles. Normal winter temperatures in June and July don't typically fall under 50 degrees Fahrenheit, and normal summer temperatures in January and February stay around 70 degrees Fahrenheit. Since the seasons are turned around from that of the Northern Hemisphere, numerous Australians go to the seashore for Christmas. Populous, urbanization, and the core-periphery spatial relationship. Australia is separated politically into 6 states and 2 regions. They are the Northern Territory, Australian Capital Territory, Western Australia, Tasmania, South Australia, Queensland, and New South Wales. Australian protectorates are made out of various little islands around Australia. Australian centre regions are helpful for huge human populaces. To find the centre populous territories in Australia, basically track down the moderate type C environments. Australia has two centre districts. There is a little centre area in the west, moored by the city of Perth. The majority of Australia's kin live in the huge centre locale in the east along the coast. This district stretches out from Brisbane to Adelaide and holds the greater part of the nation's populace. The all-out populace of Australia in 2010 was distinctly around 22 million. There are a greater number of individuals living in Mexico City than on the whole of Australia. In excess of 90% of this populace has European legacy. The majority of this rate is from the British Isles. English is the prevailing language. Christianity is the prevailing religion of decision. The cosmetics of individuals is a result of European imperialism and migration. Just around 2% of the current populace comprises of Aboriginal individuals, the first individuals of Australia. Australia's populace has seen occasional development sprays as influxes of outsiders reacted to public strategies empowering migration. This was particularly obvious after World War II. Around 24% of the current populace was brought into the world external Australia. Most come from the United Kingdom, and another huge rate comes from New Zealand. Asian nations have likewise added to the Australian populace, with quantifiable quantities of outsiders from China, Vietnam, and the Philippines. Furthermore, ultimately, individuals from Italy and India likewise make up a prominent extent of Australia's outsider populace. Australia's populace isn't spread uniformly across the scene, since a huge bit of the nation is desert. The populace is moved generally in the metropolitan zones. Around 90% of the populace occupies the urban communities, which are for the most part in waterfront regions. The biggest city, Sydney, is regularly alluded to as the New York of Australia. Sydney is situated at the core of the principal centre region, the territory of New South Wales. Toward the south of Sydney is the Australian Capital Territory, home to the capital city of Canberra. Other significant Australian urban communities incorporate Melbourne, Perth, Adelaide, and Brisbane. Hobart is the biggest city on the island of Tasmania and Darwin is the biggest city in the Northern Territory. Every one of the huge urban communities of Australia, with aside from the arranged capital city of Canberra, are situated on the coast. This example of metropolitan circulation was a result of European frontier advancement. A large portion of Australia's populace lives in the two financial centre areas, so Australia displays a particular centre fringe spatial example. The centre territories hold the influence, riches, and impact while the outskirts area supplies all the food, crude materials, and products required in the centre. Australia has never had a dominant part rustic populace since its Aboriginal occasions. There has been minimal provincial to metropolitan move in Australia's populace. This is like Japan's metropolitan advancement design. English is the primary language of by far most of the populace. As of late, authorized approaches and changing mentalities toward multiculturalism have prodded development in the quantity of foreigners and their relatives who communicate in two dialects fluidly, English and the language of their origination or public legacy. Native dialects have not fared so well. Upwards of 300 native dialects were spoken by Aborigines before the Europeans showed up, and only a couple hundred years after the fact, that number presently remains at around 70. Most native dialects are at risk for vanishing. Culture and immigration. Until 1973, Australia had an assortment of laws and approaches known as the White Australia Strategy, which served to restrict the movement of non-white people to Australia. While the White Australia arrangements restricted migration from certain territories, different strategies tried to extend movement from the United Kingdom. Endowments were offered to British residents to migrate to Australia. Somewhere in the range of 1830 and 1940, in excess of 1 million British residents exploited the offer. Ongoing statistics information show that about a fourth of the populace distinguishes itself as Roman Catholic and another 20% self-recognizes as Anglican, the public religion of the United Kingdom. An extra 20% self-recognize as Protestant, other than Anglican, and around 15% as having no religion. Ordinary church participation is guaranteed by at about 7.5% of the populace. Regardless of current Australia having been settled by the British, Australian law proclaims that Australia will have no public religion and ensures opportunity of religion. Sports are a significant piece of Australian culture, may be inferable from an environment that takes into account all year outside movement. About a fourth of the populace is associated for certain sort of coordinated games group. Football, soccer, is famous, as is valid in most European nations, and rugby and cricket are mainstream also. The most famous observer sport in Australia is Australian rules football, otherwise called Aussie rules football, or basically, footy. This remarkably Australian game has systematized decides that date back to 1858 and is a variation of football and rugby. Different types of amusement incorporate TV, film, and live exhibitions of each sort. In spite of the fact that Australia has some of its own TV channels, there are worries that mainstream society is starting to be overwhelmed by American impacts. Australia's enormous urban areas have broad projects in human expressions. Sydney is turning into a middle for elite exhibitions in dance, drama, music, and theatre. Schooling is all around financed and universally regarded. School participation is obligatory between the ages of 6 and 15, and the grown-up proficiency rate has held consistent at around 99%. Most understudies go to freely supported schools, which are common. Non-public schools, which charge educational expenses, do exist and are regularly run by strict associations, transcendently the Catholic Church. Monetary geography. The greater part of Australia, particularly the wide territory of the parched inside known as the Outback, has massive open spaces, rural potential or superb asset extraction prospects. The broad fields support a huge number of tamed creatures, fundamentally dairy cattle and sheep, which represents up to one-fifth of the world's fleece creation. Huge agrarian organizations incorporate large number of sections of land under one activity. The western area of the Great Dividing Range in New South Wales is a superb district for business grain activities. The seaside area in Queensland, since it is hotter and gets more precipitation, is useful for sugarcane and comparative harvests. Sheep and cows farms are regular in focal Queensland and Western Australia. Different districts of Southern Australia are magnificent for grape and natural product creation. Australian wine creation has ascended to contend with the US and European business sectors. Just the dry focal desert areas in the focal point of the landmass are not good for agribusiness. In the early segment of the 20th century, Australia acquired tremendous abundance by trading food items to the remainder of the world. This is still evident, however, the overall revenue on food products is no longer what it used to be. The nation has needed to look somewhere else to acquire abundance. Australia has incredible food creation capacities. It additionally has a superb mineral asset base. Various sorts of minerals can be found in various areas all through Australia. Western Australia has iron mineral mines. The eastern locale of Queensland and New South Wales has plentiful coal saves. Minerals like zinc, copper, gold, silver, tungsten, and nickel can be found in different pieces of the nation, including Tasmania. Oil and gas fields can be found in the northwestern beachfront waters and in the Tasman Sea east of Melbourne. The nation is independent in flammable gas yet needs to import some oil-based goods. Are any Australian-made items accessible where you reside? What items would you be able to consider? Australia doesn't trade many fabricated products. Its fundamental fares are food and crude materials. On the off chance that you recollect how nations acquire riches, the technique with the most noteworthy esteemed added benefit is fabricating. Consider Japan and the four Asian monetary tigers, and how they have acquired their riches. The monetary tigers have not many crude materials. Where do you guess the financial tigers in Japan get their crude materials? With Japan's tremendous assembling limit, it has an appeal for imported iron metal, minerals, and crude materials. In spite of the fact that Australia is a previous British settlement, Great Britain isn't viewed as Australia's biggest exchanging accomplice. Australia is nearer geologically to the Asian Monetary Local Area than to the European Union. Japan has become Australia's greatest exchanging accomplice. At the point when Australia is seen in the information, in TV programs, and in Hollywood motion pictures, it is depicted as a country with a comparable way of life to the United States or Europe. How do Australians have an elevated requirement of living on the off chance that they don't make anything for trade? To assess this, consider the size of the number of inhabitants in Australia and think about the dissemination of riches. They trade a tremendous measure of crude materials and have a moderately little populace to share the abundance. Australia is an appealing spot to visit. The climate, the creatures, and the way of life make it welcoming for the travel industry. As of the year 2002, the travel industry has become Australia's main methods for financial pay. From the Great Barrier Reef and the Gold Coast to the huge spread of the outback, Australia has been showcasing itself as an appealing spot to visit with incredible achievement. The travel industry from Japan gives an enormous level of the vacationer action. Australia has traveled through the underlying phases of the list of financial improvement to turn into a general public that is around 90% metropolitan with little families and big league salaries. Mining and Aboriginal lands. Regional control of Australian terrains has become a significant issue as of late. Enormous segments of Western Australia and the outback have generally been Aboriginal terrains. European expansionism on the Australian landmass uprooted a significant number of the local individuals. Huge areas of land once utilized by the Aborigines were taken over by the public authority or by private interests. Huge agrarian activities and mining tasks have utilized the terrains without sufficient pay to the Aboriginal individuals who once controlled them. Court decisions focused on repayment for local individuals have had blended outcomes. There are upwards of 400 distinct gatherings of Aborigines at present in Australia that make up an absolute populace of around 450,000. This is a little level of Australia's populace, however, includes an enormous piece of the actual region of the country. Their property claims incorporate the entirety of the Northern Territory, a huge segment of Western Australia, and parts of South Australia and Queensland. This is notwithstanding claims situated inside numerous metropolitan zones, like the biggest city, Sydney. Mining procedure on Aboriginal terrains have gotten exceptionally managed. Concerns have emerged that Australia's extractive enterprises will decrease, causing a decrease in the economy. The worry for the Aboriginal populace has expanded in the previous few decades, and the public authority has made endeavours to intervene their political and monetary issues just as fortify projects that address their social government assistance. Australia's future. The monetary eventual fate of Australia is unpredictable. In spite of the fact that travel industry has become a practical methods for turning out revenue, Australia should import made items that it doesn't create locally, including electronic products, PCs, and vehicles. Import reliance has expanded its import-export imbalance. Economic alliance and protectionism have become a piece of the monetary riddle of how to support a serious way of life. Australia is situated close to the Asian domain. Its economy, culture, and future are getting more Asian. Migration has been an issue in that the public authority has consistently confined movement to guarantee an European dominant part. A huge number of Asian individuals might want to relocate to Australia to look for more prominent freedoms and benefits, however they are lawfully limited. It is getting more hard for Australians to hold to their European associations with a particularly Asian presence. How the nation will deal with the present circumstance later on will demonstrate intriguing. Thank you for watching. Bye now.
If you enjoyed this video, be sure to give it a like and subscribe to Life is Often. If you haven't already, click the bell icon to stay updated on all our latest content.